Hey everyone, welcome back to another Counterside video. So today we will be discussing a build guide for Awakened Yuna. But before that, if you want an updated Counterside videos, please hit the subscribe button down below. Okay, so here we are at Awakened Yuna Springfield. So her deployment cost is actually 6, similar to Awakened Hilde. She is an Awakened SSR, of course. Awakened Striker, ground type, and she is actually a all-around attacker, which is actually awesome for an Awakened unit. So far we don't have one yet, so she is the first for the Awakened units. And also when we go to her stat, so I'll be classifying her stats into two types. So her strengths, the strengths would be around your high and above average, and your weakness would be below average and your low stat. So for her strengths, she is going to have HP and attack. Her HP max before you add the other additions for her gear would be 52,761, which is a very high stat. And her attack is 5,934, which is also a very high stat. For her weakness, actually all of the four remaining stats are her weakness. Defense, crit, hit, and evasion, they are actually below average in terms of the overall stat that we have. But for defense, she has 684. Crit, she has 684 again. Hit is 559. And evasion is going to be at 653. The good thing about her below average stat is it's easier to bump up to above average. Okay? So we don't usually have an average stat because that's very, you know, that's very subjective. But again, it's usually going to be below average and above average. Okay guys, so for her skills, she actually has her basic attack is actually two valid hits, summons flames inflicting AoE damage on enemies in front after every fifth basic attack. Riley, her phoenix, actually delivers an AoE attack to the farthest target and decreases its attack and attack speed by 30%. So because of this, there is a secondary option. This is only a secondary option for your set option, which is going to be attack speed, but preferably she's going to be a cooldown reduction, so that she can trigger the fifth basic attack, the extra damage to the furthest target. So that is the only reason why, if you don't have cooldown, you can actually use attack speed, increasing attack speed. Okay, so levels 2, 3, 4, and 5, her basic attack damage will be total of plus 20. Next would be her passive skill, so Riley. So her phoenix again, summons Riley when deployed. Yuna decreases HP by 2% every second for herself and surrounding enemies. So she gets an automatic damage to the enemies around her, except bosses and ships excluded as well, and recovers 3% of HP every second if Riley is on the field. So basically she gains 1% every time the 3% negates the 2, so it's a plus 1 as long as Riley is in the field. Okay, so Riley resurrects in 5 seconds with full HP once per summon. Again, she can be killed and resurrected, then you have her again, then you if you kill a Riley the second time, then she's gone forever. Next would be her the additional stats. So level 2, 3, and 4, attack is going to be a plus 12 total. At level 5, if Riley is dead, damage taken minus 50%, and special ultimate skill HP restoration plus 50% for 5 seconds. So again, she receives a buff when Riley is dead. Okay, for her special skill, which is Solar Flame, so it's it has a 20% 20 second cooldown, valid hits is 3, so an AoE, summons a massive column of fire inflicting AoE damage on and around the target. Targets lose their buff effects and can't receive new buffs for 6 seconds, which is very much pretty amazing, especially if she pulls this off early. Yuna also recovers 10% of HP if Riley is on the field. So again, it's a very good skill because she self-sustains herself in terms of HP reduction. So levels 2, 3, 4 would be a total damage addition of 25%. But on level 5, damage taken is a minus 15% for 8 seconds when cast. So effect doubled if Riley is on the field. So it's going to be a minus 30%. So Riley is actually the key for her, you know, for her long survival. Ultimate skill, prominence. It's a 52-second cooldown. Valid hits 4. Concentrates and discharges the power of the sun, inflicting AoE damage on enemies in front. Recovers 20% of HP if Riley is on the field. Okay, again, Riley is the key. Level 2, 3, and 4, damage is a total plus of 25%. But on level 5, she gains an attack plus for 12 seconds after skill. Effect doubled if Riley is on the field. So again, it's a plus of 30% if Riley is on the field. So the key here, guys, is really to bump up her, what do you call this, her cooldown reduction. So in line with that, we're going to move to her gear sets. Okay, guys, so this is actually my Yuna. So I've taken her to level 100 already. I'm sorry. I had to because I was getting my butt kicked in ranked PvP, so I had to. And there are already a lot of Yunas out there, so I had to build her up. And let's focus first on her gear. So more or less the gear set that I am primarily recommending is actually cooldown, so cooldown reduction. And the secondary, again, as I mentioned before, was attack speed. If you don't have any cooldown, attack speed would be okay, but preferably 90% of the time you should use cooldown reduction as your gear set. Okay, in terms of, for example, the gear stat, the secondary priority would be let's move to the other. So I have her at skill haste. I've given her a lot of skill haste for the secondary skills here, the skills in yellow. So as you can see here, the others are also in yellow skill haste. So again, make sure that she has a lot of skill haste. Secondary would be HP for her survivability and for, again, for healing purposes. And also the last skill that you would want to put here in her secondary skill or primary skill would be evasion. So again, these are the skills that she is going to be equipped with. So again, make sure that cooldown is going to be your core set and skill for your awakened Yuna Springfield. Okay, let's go to deployment management. Okay, in short, Yuna is going to be terrific overall. Air, ground units. She is actually tanky, but I would highly recommend that you guys still have a tank in front of her, so that it could increase more of her sustainability in the battlefield, especially in especially in PvP ranked, because again, I'm sure she is not a pure defender, but she's just a tanky striker. So you could have Serapel put in front of her, have them combo, because based on what I've seen, if you combo her with Awakened Hilde, the cost is pretty much ridiculous. Even if you put one as a leader, that's 11 total. So again, for you to have a more efficient combo with a defender, probably a 3-cost, 4-cost defender, you have their Liu Mi, you have their Reginald King, you also have again, Serapel is the newest one, which I highly recommend you build as well if you have her. By the way, I'm going to put out also a build guide for Serapel. So after this, probably by tomorrow, I'll have that same guide as well. Let's try to use her skills and check out. Actually, she has a lot of animations because she is attacking as well as Riley is attacking. And let's try to use her ultimate. I like the way her eyes are colored. So the one is green, one is orange. So again, I really like her design. She actually floats a bit. She doesn't really fly, she just floats. But I think she can fly. So more or less, again, very impressive in terms of how she is built, how she is designed. Because again, she is going to be one of the top three or top two awakened SSRs in quite a while, from what I see, with how she is built, how she's going to be played. So again, very good design. I'm actually happy that she was actually out this week already. Okay, guys, so as for my final thoughts, Yuna is going to be dominating PvP for a while. She might even scooch over Awakened Hilde. She might. I will have to see that and test that as well, if she's worthy of that primary, you know, primary alpha Awakened SSR on your PvP team. But she is definitely going to be here for a while. So as for PvP, she PvP counter side Southeast Asia, she's going to be here. Again, I've rated her at 10 out of 10 as of the game now. Even in terms of the future proofing, she would just drop a little bit around the 9/10. Okay, so she is actually top one right now, or top two in terms of awakened units to be used in PvP. And for PvE, of course, she is the queen of PvP, and she is no doubt a must in terms of future content in this game. She is good in all PvP, and she is a 10 out of 10, except for raids. That's just it. She is very good overall in PvP, in PvE, sorry. And she will actually help you very much if you just build her, especially up to level 110, which is actually, you know, I think a must for you to be competitive in both game modes, such as PvP and PvE. Anyway, guys, if you have stuck this far in this video, please consider subscribing and also click that bell icon and also put a like to this video. Guys, take care. Stay safe. This is the Warden, and I'm out of here.